Many scientists say that we know more about outer space than the depths of our oceans. While we've given our planet's oceans separate names, in reality, there's no border between them, and currents continually flow between them and mix their waters. The Atlantic and Pacific Oceans are the two largest seas on the planet, covering half of the Earth's surface, meet at the southernmost tip of South America called Cape Horn. According to topographers, the line that marks the border between the Atlantic and the Pacific Ocean runs straight between Cape Horn and Antarctica. In this region, a strong current carries water from west to east, sweeping water from the Pacific into the Atlantic. On the other side of the planet, the Gulf of Alaska, an arm of the Pacific Ocean, holds a spectacular view which seems to be the confluence of two oceans, whereas it is actually the glacial meltwater meeting the offshore waters. The color variations found here draw a clear line between these two oceans. The heavier clay materials with iron and sediments at that harbor at the Gulf make the waters at Gulf appear darker than the glacial meltwaters. The reason for this strange phenomenon is due to the differences in water density. The salinity and temperatures of both these oceans keep their waters demarked and separated. This phenomenon is called water stratification. The nutrients present don't mix, and the photosynthesis process for the plankton present in oceans is limited. Hence, the concentration of planktons present also differs, which in turn absorbs light and scatter in different directions. The mixing boundary is, of course, a curve, but on the surface, it seems like a zigzag line, or like a boundary. But it isn't only the truth. What you see is the extreme level of mixing of waters. It may change with time and temperature, but due to the large volume of both the waters, change is negligible and have a fixed zone. It seems amazing and like a miracle. Yes, it is a miracle, miracle of science and nature.